Send forth your spirit into the lives of these graduates. May they leave our school filled with love for all creation. Let them strive to share their knowledge with gentle patience and endeavor always to bring the truth to all people. We pray you to guard and protect them. Keep them from harm's way. May hope accompany their journey through all the days to come. May the blessings promised to the compassionate be theirs in abundance. And may your abiding presence be with them all the days of their lives. We ask all these things through Christ, the model teacher, our brother and Lord, forever and ever. Amen. The Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you. there's nothing else you remember from this world but the dead. Remember that we love you, and we expect you to continue to open your hearts, minds, ears, and arms to truly love and serve others as you move into the next chapter of your life. So here we are. Wow, we did it. You did it. Moments ago, I referenced the pandemic, and we cannot move on without stating the obvious challenges that brought along its wake since September, and for some of us since March 13th, to be exact. Social distancing, staying within your cohort, wearing a mask. I can go on and on about the many about what many feel on the negatives, but I prefer to remind you of all the positives and all the growth that was achieved this year. You became attentive listeners. The mask made it so very difficult to read facial expressions, and when participating in conversation, you have to be extra attentive to the words, most times muffled by a mask. This made you more intentional in your messaging and thoughtful in your response, thus a better communicator overall. You became a more caring and considerate individual, and you had to be cognizant of your personal space and that of others to ensure health and safety at all times. This made you more mindful of the needs of others as well as yourself. You had to Zoom, mute screens, speak and listen without seeing faces of remote friends, click, copy, save, download, etc. I know in the end it came easy to you. Parents, take note of your savvy graduates when you're in tech jam, please. However, these particular challenges allowed you to build upon your skill set that you will certainly need in the very near future and beyond. You were pushed quite a bit, I may add, out of your comfort zone. When you wanted to engage with another in conversation or game,
continue to acknowledge how God loves us, we'll be quick and quiet in the halls, and of course, we'll always strive to be academically excellent. Hopefully, we'll be able to repay you for your actions by doing all that you have taught us. Our class would also like to thank Father Rasser and Father Clark for their spiritual guidance. Thank you for always being open to our questions and helping us grow in your faith. Big thank you to Mr. Carlos and the rest of the maintenance staff for working diligently to keep our school clean and sanitized, especially during this pandemic. Of course, I cannot forget the lovely Mrs. Funes for always making sure everyone is healthy and taking care of all our medical needs. Mrs. Funes has always been great at helping me whenever I had problems with asthma or even when I just scraped my knee. She's always been there to tend to us careless children after falling outside or running into another child at gym. The faculty and staff at SMS are the most devoted and vested group of individuals you could ever meet. Everything they do is for the students. Even if we are no longer in their classes or have never even had them as teachers, they will always stop us in the halls to make sure everything is all right, and of course, to teach us if they feel time is right. We want to thank all the teachers we've had, the ones who are still here, and the ones who have retired or departed from the SMS community. The class of 2021 is a very diverse group of students. Some have been here since pre-K-3, and some have joined us just this year. One thing is for sure, we will all have a lasting bond from our amazing teacher, Mrs. Dulaney. We are all incredibly thankful and lucky to have been united through her. We can all agree that Mrs. Dulaney has worked day and night ensuring that not only we have the best 8th grade year, but that we leave knowing that we are prepared for high school. She has done an incredible job explaining topics to us, making sure we understand, and ensuring that we leave SMS with good test-taking skills and strong study habits. Around the time high school acceptance letters came out, she noticed how stressed and nervous we all were. She took time from a busy day to allow us to relax and decompress. We spent the entire class staring at cute animals in a zoo. This is just one of the many times Mrs. Delaney has been there for us. I don't know how we would have gotten through this year without her. There is not enough time in the world to fully express our gratitude for her. Thank you, Mrs. Delaney. Now, we can't thank all these amazing people without thanking our parents. You are the reason we are here today. Thank you for believing in us and encouraging us when we needed it. Most importantly, thank you for sending us to St. Margaret's School. It's probably one of the best decisions you could have made. We can't repay you for sending us to this Catholic school, but we promise to work our best and take every opportunity to make you proud of the money you spend on our education. We promise not to take anything for granted because we're so fortunate for everything you do for us. We love you so much. Every moment spent at SMS, every experience, has been turned into a valuable lesson. St. Margaret's has been more than just a school. It has been a safe place and a home. Not only has it been a place of learning, but it's been a place for us to mature into intelligent young adults. I've attended St. Margaret's School for 11 years. SMS is my second home. And to finally graduate is something my three-year-old self would have never imagined. Sure, I've experienced countless long bells and slideshows, but not once did I ever think it would be my friends and me in these rooms. Whether we're new friends or old, I'm so glad we got to do this together. We shared laughs, tears, food, toys, and so much more. The most meaningful thing to me is that I get to share this moment with all of my friends. Graduating SMS is not just the end of an era. It's the foundation to a new and exciting journey. Many of us might be scared of what the future brings. We ask ourselves if we're prepared. Are we ready for the next step in our lives? The answer to that may still be unknown, but what I know is that attending St. Margaret's School has given us the best opportunity to succeed. I've been asked a few questions often from
gathered here this morning to thank God, first and foremost, the proper way, for all the gifts and blessings and talents that God has given you, and you in turn will give to all of us. So maybe not now, or even in the next few years, but certainly in the future, don't ever forget what was given to you here at SMS. You have received an education, the foundation stones of all the future education that you will ever have. It was an education based on Catholic values, an education that tells us that God is real and that God matters, and that because he matters, so does the work of his hands in creation. And the greatest and height of all of his creation is you, the human person. Every human person is made in the image and the likeness of God. And even before they open their mouth and do anything, they have a respect and a dignity that belongs to them simply because they're human beings. That you were taught. Now you must go out and live. So tonight, say goodbye. Goodbye to the classrooms, but never the lessons that are taught there. Goodbye to your teachers, but not to their guidance that will direct you in the days ahead. Goodbye to your uniforms, not the spirit of St. Margaret's that you wore upon your chest. Goodbye to your classmates, but not to your lifelong friends. For you, the alumni class of 2021, you have been claimed by history. You will be written about in history books. Your children and your grandchildren will ask you about these days that you lived, times you've experienced. And you, like the class of, say, 1941, or the class of 1918, or even the class of 1968, you experienced a unique moment in history. And like the class of 41, or 18, or 68, something from outside changed the course of your life, all our lives, the course of your story. And you fought the good fight. You ran the good race. And today you have finished that race and you receive the reward of your diploma. Always, my friends, always have a grateful heart. Let the words thank you flow easily and naturally from your lips. For no matter what this world may throw at you, always do the right thing. Always do the noble thing. And as you learn here at St. Margaret's, it's the right thing to do. As you leave us here, know how proud we are of all of you. And with great interest, we will hear of your great progress. Remember always to seek the truth, to do the good, and to love the beautiful. So, my young friends, send you on your way to live your life, which quietly lies ahead of all of you. Keep God first. Keep your faith strong. And no matter what may happen to you, you'll always be victorious. You'll overcome all obstacles because you and God will always win together. I say to you, as someone who taught high school for a number of years, enjoy high school. Try out for clubs and sports that you never thought of, that you never could or would even think
I use this one. Father Rasser says, I'm a teacher, but I don't have a teacher's voice. You know, the great thing about what Father Rasser says, you know, a blessing in the church is a unique gift, because what the church sends you off with is the greatest of all gifts. It's God himself. And to lay out what Father Rasser said this morning, which is so important, the most important part of the ceremony was actually this morning, Baccalaureate Mass, at the Mass, which celebrate in the context of the Mass. And I think it's important as we leave today to take one particular image I want to take with you today from this morning's feast, which was, of course, is still the feast of course, the Sacred Heart of Jesus. And in the morning, this morning reading, there are two things that flowed from the heart of Jesus this morning, water and blood. And for God, blood is an important symbol because it symbolizes life. And water, an important symbol because it sustains life. And these two imagery are very important. When I grew up, I didn't have television, but I had a television of a sort, and I love to watch streams, love rivers. And I'd like to leave you before the blessing with this imagery of water, because that's what we do in this house, baptism, sacraments, all of it, this idea of grace and water. And you can learn very important things from streams that I can challenge you. You'll never learn from schools or universities. They can teach you beautiful things. And two imagery I like to leave you as you're going to leave out. It's amazing to watch as within the river you'll have stone with no shape. They have rough edges. And you can watch as the water will take those rough edges and shape them into smooth stone. Amazingly. But doing this work, plus everything as the river does, depends on the purity of the river. And the purity of the river depends upon the source from which the water flows. If the source of the water is polluted and dirty, the work of the river or the stream will be polluted and dirty. Why is this image so important? Your words that will come from your mouth are like streams, flowing streams. Your actions are like rivers, flowing streams. And I want you to understand, I want you to grasp, is the value and excellence and worth of your words and actions will depend on the source from which they come. Very important. What will set God different as a teacher from the Harvards and the Columbias of the world is a man's actions and words depend upon their character. Their character, the source from which all their words and action flows, will give value, excellence, virtue to their words and their actions. And for the universities around the world, they believe it's the mind. And if you ask God, God would say, no, it's not the mind, really. It's really the heart. The kind of heart you have. That's the source from which all words, all your conversations, all your discourses, all your actions flow. And if your heart is pure, then guess what? Your words and actions will be a great value of excellence, great aid and support, not just to your family, but to the world in general. And so as you leave this house, I want you to remember what Father Rasser said this morning. What will make us distinctive is a Catholic education. We always take God first. Because unlike the rest of the world, and the Harvards and the Columbia, the invitation that we have from God is to make of yourself a new heart. And as you go into the world, this place, St. Margaret of Antioch, churches and churches like this, this is what our entire work of faith is all about. Purifying our hearts so that our words and our actions will be and will make a great difference in the world. Before the final blessing, therefore, I'll tell you what I always tell Catholic students all the time. Whenever you go into the world, you have three options. You can make the world a better place. You can make it a worse place. But if your choice is not to make it a better place, at least do the world a favor and leave it the way you found it. And if you're going to leave it the way you found it, then don't speak. Don't do anything. But that's not possible. And so we as Catholics are reminded what we're called to do. We're called to make a difference in the world. Not to make it a worse place, but to make it a better place. It's why we bear the name Christians. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you always, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.